Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 12 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I showed you how to do image overlays. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to do video overlays. And I got some great news for you guys. If you followed along in video number 11, where I did the image overlays, you're going to notice that a lot of the things that we're doing are identical. But please do watch this video anyway, because I'm going to try to cover some additional things as we're doing this process that maybe I didn't have a chance to talk about in the previous video. So let's get started by going down to the Add menu, and we're going to select the movie that we want to overlay over the Big Buck Bunny movie that I've already imported into the sequencer. And that movie will be Tears of Steel. Now, you'll notice that it started the strips at the location of the green line, just like with the image import. And let's skip ahead to see what we have here. Now, you can see that this guy's face is a little bit elongated, and that's because the resolution of this video strip is actually 1280 by 534, and the Big Buck Bunny video strip is 1280 by 720. And we selected the resolution of Big Buck Bunny to be the official render size that we put into our render settings over here, 1280 by 720. So the preview window is going to show the previews at 1280 by 720. So that's why this guy's face is stretched out. But we can quickly fix that using what we did in the last video, the image offset option. We click on the video that we want to fix, and we go down to the properties and we click the magical image offset checkbox, and now everything's to the right proportions. Now what do we have to do? Well, we can see that it's supposed to be showing the Big Buck Bunny video behind this, but it's not, and that's because we haven't told Blender that this is to be used as an overlay. So we need to go to the properties window for the Tears of Steel strip and select overdrop, and now you can see the top of the head of Big Buck Bunny showing through. So that's working. Now, what do we want to do? We want to transform the video of Tears of Steel. We want to shrink it down. So what we need to do is create a transform layer. Now, I'm going to actually delete the audio for the upper overlay video because, frankly, I generally don't use the audio when I'm playing something up in a box, you know. But you guys could actually keep the audio, but for just to simplify this tutorial, I'm going to delete it. So let's hit delete. Now let's click on our video strip that we want to transform and go down to the Add menu and select Effect Strip, Transform. And that creates our transform layer. And remember what I always say, whenever you create a transform layer, always mute or hide the strip that you transformed from. So we're going to take this original strip right here, and we're going to go down to the strip menu, and we're going to select mute strips. Now, something I didn't emphasize in the previous video when I told you to do this was that you can't delete the original strip because the transform layer is actually referencing the original strip. You notice that the transform strip does not have a handle on it? Well, how do you think you actually change the frame range of the transform strip? We have to grab the handle of the original strip. So I'll show you how that works. I'm going to right click on the handle of the original strip, hit the G button and pull to the side, and you can see it actually utilizes the handle of the original strip. And that is why we cannot delete it. Okay, so let's go and change the settings of this transform strip by right-clicking on the transform strip, going down to the properties window, and we're going to go to the uniform scale option, and we're going to click our left button over the scale, and we're going to shrink it down to the size that we like. But guess what? We just told this that it was supposed to be an overlay. Why is it not showing us the background? Well, whenever you create a transform strip, it requires that you reset the blend settings for that strip as well. So we've already resized it. Now let's go up to our blend settings in the properties window and we'll select overdrop, and now that's fixed. Now let's go back down And we're going to change the position by left-clicking on the XY coordinates and dragging it to a place that we like. That will do. And now I'm going to show you guys that when we hit the play button, it's going to play not only the underlying video, but the video that is overlaying. So let's hit that play button. And that's how you do video overlays. See you guys in the next video.